We are the painters of our world. We are creators.
My next guest is Starquita Washington. Starquita is a graduate of LA Southwest College, a California community college. After graduation from Southwest, she took advantage of the Guaranteed Transfer Program and went to Bethune-Cookman University and HBCU in Daytona Beach, Florida. And she's here to tell you all about her journey. Starquita, it is a pleasure to have you here today.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
Let's take you back to 2008. You graduated high school that year. What did you think was next for you at that time?
I honestly didn't have a clue what was next. I know I wanted to go to college, but I was just an 18-year-old, just lost. Was like, I just want to just graduate and just work.
You actually waited a little longer to start your college experience. Tell us about that.
So I waited, like I just wanted to work, but then looking at my friends graduate, and I'm like, 4 years passed already, 3 years passed. So I'm like, Starquita, you got to get up and go to school. You got a high school diploma, it's okay, but you got to do something more. So then that's when I was like, you know, I'm going to start off small. I was like, I'm going to just get an AA degree. But once you in school, it's that adrenaline. Like, you just keep learning and learning, and you just can't stop. So that's what it is now, and I just want to keep going.
Tell me about your experience at LA Southwest College. What was it like?
Great. It was great. At first, I was a little bit nervous because of the age that I was at the time. But I went to the counselor, and he just helped me get my classes, and it made it very smooth, and it was actually really easy for me.
So how did community college at LA Southwest prepare you for going to an HBCU?
It's made it more easier because I, just trying to step into a four-year college, I wouldn't think I would have done it because I would have been confused and lost. But a community college, they actually take their time with you, and they set out a goal. You have it's a pathway, so you start till it tells you where do you want to go. Because at a community college, you have one major, and then what if you're not interested to that? So you can always change. So by them taking your time, and it's actually very focused, so it kind of helped for 2 years instead of going straight to a four-year.
Now, there are a lot of advantages to going to an HBCU, and I heard one of them is class size. Did you find that to be true at Bethune-Cookman?
Yes, the class sizes are really small, which is a good thing because you have that one-on-one with the students as well and with your teachers. So as opposed to being in a larger, you don't get your question asked and they take the time with you, because average classroom size is probably 40, 30, but theirs probably was like 15 or 20. So it was good.
So I'm assuming there may have been some cost savings by going to a community college prior to going to an HBCU, right?
Definitely. Like I said, you do your research and it helps you, because if you're going, it ties down to how much cost is, and it tells you which community college, which schools you want to go to, what HBCUs you want to go to. So they help you break down everything. So that actually helps you as well.
Now, you're the first in your family to graduate from college. How did your family respond to your higher education journey?
They were excited. They were kind of nervous. You know, I just went to school, so they were just like, okay, you're just going to go to school. And I'm like, yeah. So my grandpa, which is my biggest inspiration, so my grandpa recently passed away Christmas Eve. He was 112. So
wait, what?
He was 112.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah. So he inspired me a lot to continue to go to school. So I was like, well, I have no kids, but I can give you a degree. So my birthday gift to him was to give him a degree.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
So what would you say to someone who's interested in attending college, whether starting at a community college or going to an HBCU?
I encourage everybody to go to college, no matter how old, what age. It's never too late to go back. And I speak for myself because it took me a long time, but I'm here now. I graduated. I'm still going no matter what.
Now, you and I are having a conversation prior to the interview about you growing up in South Central. There's someone watching right now, potentially from that area or an area like that. What would you say to that person that believes that they can't do what you're now doing?
Take the vocabulary, I can't, first of all, out their mouth and say I can and I will go, because you don't want to have other people in your ear. And I think I was that person oh, the school's not for me. School is a scam. So you'll often hear that a lot. But I would just say follow your own path and you can be greater than them, because when I look back at it, I still know some people that's still in stage one and I'm in stage five. So I would just say just get up and go, and, you know, you're going to get made fun of. They're going to talk about you. But it's just like you're making your own pathway. So it's your future, not theirs.
Thank you so much for your story, for your patience, and your time.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
We are the painters of our world. We are.